Hello students, today we will discuss about numericals on Snell's law. So numericals based on Snell's law. Question number 1. Let me explain the question and I will draw the diagram for this question. The question is that the ray of light is incident on a refracting surface. That means the surface where refraction will take place. Now, that surface is water. So, this is a water surface and the ray strikes the water surface like so. It says that the ray strikes the water surface at an angle of 60 degree on the surface of water, at an angle of incidence of 60 degree. So, which angle is 60 degree? The angle of incidence is 60 degree. This is given. What is given? So, at this point, we'll draw a normal. The angle of incidence is the angle between the incident ray and the normal. So, this is 60 degree given. The ray is deviated through 15 degree towards the normal when it enters the water. That means it should have gone straight like this, but instead of going straight it will bend because this part is air and this part is water. So when light enters from air to water, from rarer medium to denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. So therefore it will bend towards the normal, something like this. This is the incident ray, this is the refracted ray. By what angle? So this angle is called angle of refraction. This angle is called angle of incidence. This angle is called angle of deviation. So it says that it is deviated through 15 degree towards the normal. So instead of going this direction, it bends towards the normal by 15 degree. So this is 15 degree. This is given. Find the refractive index of water. That means refractive index of water, that is with respect to air, or that is absolute refractive index of water. Now here is the solution. We use Snell's law to solve this question. What is Snell's law? It says that if I say the refractive index of this medium is mu A with respect to absolute refractive index of air with respect to itself is 1, that is there, that we'll discuss right now afterwards. The refractive index of water is mu W with respect to obviously air. We know that the Snell's law is mu A. Applying Snell's law, mu A sine of this angle I equals to mu W sine of R. This is always true. This is Snell's law. Now, this value is 1. Because this is air, this is also air, absolute refractive index. The refractive index of a medium with respect to itself is always 1. This is sine of 60 degree. How come is this? This angle is 60. So therefore this angle will also be 60. From this I will subtract this angle which is 15 degree. So this remaining angle R is 60 minus 15, that is I minus delta. Therefore this is 45. This implies
this is root 3 over 2 sine 60, and sine 45 is 1 upon root 2. So this is root of 3 by 2 that you solve it to get root of 3 is 1.73, and this is root of 2 is if I take it up, it is 0.7. So it will be nearly 1.224, nearly. And we have to take the root, obviously. This comes out to be 0.86 and 0.7, which comes out to be 1.224. This is the answer to this question. So what we have done, nothing. This is a very simple law that is called Snell's law. You take the refractive index of a medium and multiply the refractive index with the corresponding sign of the angle of incidence in that medium. Similarly, here the refractive index of this medium and sign of the corresponding angle of refraction of this medium. So sign of angle of incidence or sign of angle of refraction, you multiply that, and the product is always constant even if you change the medium. So therefore, at this point where you want to apply Snell's law, you always use this, so that will always give you the right answer. Okay, thank you.